Woodcock are a shared resource between Canada and the United States, and they are a federally protected migratory game bird. Their management is not just one state management like white-tailed deer or wild turkey, but woodcock's management is important because the birds live in the north country, migrate to the south. There's lots of states involved, lots of, you know, different habitats. So it's important that the management that we do is done in a coherent, cohesive fashion so that we don't exploit birds in one location or another. Our region is participating in this flyway-wide effort to get woodcock banded and marked with transmitters so we can learn more about their migration biology and ecology.
Okay. So three nets,
yep.
Two nets, that's five.
We're looking at when birds are migrating through the state, how long they're stopping over, when birds that breed in New York are actually initiating their migration. And then we're trying to look at some habitat selection and connectivity, so where populations are that are breeding in New York, where they're overwintering.
If you want to pull it up, we'll figure out where the stake will go.
Woodcock fly about half an hour before sunrise and half an hour after sunset for about 5, maybe 10 minutes. So we set up mist nets in areas where birds are going to be flying through.
So last night they flushed a bird that ended up walking to the edge of the cover and flew out. So that's why we're going to cover this site with two nets so that we can increase our chances that one of those birds, if they come back, can get caught in here.
Last year was kind of a first year of learning how to catch these birds and get these birds marked effectively.
And ultimately, whatever's caught here will be brought over to the other site to work. So we'll work everything at the windmill, get it all marked there, and then if there's any birds from this area, we'll bring them back.
This is a very unique opportunity with the new technologies that are out there.
These bands are provided by the bird banding lab. And it's important that we know the age and sex of these birds, that we take the numbers off these bands accurately, and then we get these reported to the feds. If a hunter were to take a woodcock and report the band, it's important that we're able to give that hunter that information of where the bird was banded and what the age and sex was of it.
Once we caught it, we'll pull it out of the mist net. We'll put it into a bird bag, which basically just keeps the bird calmer because they can't see what's happening around them and they kind of feel safe and secure in there.
Okay, now crunch it up, there you go.
We'll take the bird back to our truck and then we'll take a couple of measurements on it. We'll put a silver aluminum band on the bird's leg and then we'll put a transmitter on the bird's back. Basically, the birds just wear it just like a backpack, like you'd put on your kid going to school.
Yep. So then you want to just slide this up onto the back. Okay.
The tags should stay on the birds for about a year.
And so if everything works out for her, she should give us a location a day during fall. And then I believe during spring, she'll give us a location every day.
Once the transmitter stops functioning, the battery's dead. It'll fall off. That silver band on the bird's leg will remain until we capture it again.